everybody. Today we're going to make butternut squash soup. I know a bunch of people have been asking me. I'm finally going to do it. It's a really easy soup to make. You can actually make it in one pot under an hour, but that's not what we're going to do. We're going to roast the squash with a Vidalia onion. It adds an extra layer of flavor. It's a little longer, but good things take time, and cooking is no different. I never said this was going to be easy. I just said it was going to be delicious. So let's get started. Important tip. Online, it says it's going to take an hour to make. It's bullshit. It's going to take an hour and a half. They don't account for prep time, and they don't account for you actually gathering some of the stuff you may need. It's absolutely ridiculous. Nobody has everything just laid out on the counter, waiting to be cooked. It's preposterous. It's ridiculous. Huh. Imagine that. Let's begin.
Alright, so these are the ingredients we'll need. A whole butternut squash. The Holy Trinity, or the Mighty Trio, as they like to call it, onion, carrot, celery. Make sure you're using Vidalia onions, it adds a little extra sweetness. Some garlic, light cream, a Granny Smith apple, sage, butter, and chicken broth. I like to use collagen. Rachel Ray has broth in a box. You can use anything. I highly suggest using fat-free nothing. Don't lie and say, Joe, I followed it perfectly, but it still tastes like shit. If I found out you used fat-free broth and you're saying it was my recipe, I'm gonna beat you to death. Chicken broth, not fat-free. You can use vegetable broth, and if you use fat-free, it's not going to taste the same. So it wasn't from me. But let's start.
So let's start by cutting our squash. You can buy it pre-cut. It'll save you 15 minutes. Preheat your oven to 425, 400, depending on how hot your oven is. I cut the top off. A lot of people have different ways they do it. I half it and then peel it. Some people half it and roast the entire thing and just scoop it out. Pick your poison. So get your knife in there good, and then put your hand on top of the knife. Hey, you know what? Cut it however the hell you want it. I'm going to the hospital.
I'm going to die.
Come on, fucker. There you go. So, once you half the squash, take a spoon, something else, scoop out all the shit, throw in the garbage, and then start to peel it. Done. Once you're done with that peeling nightmare, and you take all the seeds out, just cube it. Try and make all the pieces the same size so it cooks evenly. Alright, so I originally said it was one Vidalia onion. You're going to need two Vidalia onions. One to roast the squash with, the other one for the mirepoix with the celery and the carrot in the pot. A good amount of olive oil. You can use extra virgin. You can use whatever you want. A good amount. Everything's got to be coated. An okay amount of salt. And a good amount of pepper. The pepper, when you're roasting something, really brings out the flavor. There's people that don't like pepper. They'll say it's too spicy. Usually these are old people. They can't have a lot of pepper. They say they can't digest it. These are the same people that take the bus to Atlantic City, eat the shittiest food with the most spices, and they're perfectly fine. So, if you have somebody old in your family who can't digest a lot of pepper, there's a trick to this. Lie. All right, so make sure everything's evenly coated. Slide it around there a little bit. Throw it in your oven about a half hour. When you can press a fork straight through a piece of squash, it's done. Half hour, 40 minutes, give or take. All right, so while your squash is roasting, about a half hour, start your mirepoix, as the French call it. I still have to cut the other onion and celery and carrots. Now that everything is chopped, we can throw everything into the pot. It's about a cup and a half of the carrot, onion, celery, and about 2 cups of the Granny Smith apple. Once everything's in, a little more salt, a little more pepper, give it a stir, cover it on low and slow until these babies caramelize down to greatness. If you forget the garlic, like I did, chop some up quick, throw it in, you'll be fine. Let's check on our squash. Hey. Oop. It's just about done. Check it out. Come on over. Remember I said the fork test? You can see. Ready? Done. Finished. Let it cool. Put it aside. We're done. We're just going to wait for this mirepoix. And we're going to make sage butter. So each layer adds a little extra to the dish. This is a little sage butter. Yeah, there's only a little bit of oil in there. There's a little bit of oil in there. It's about 3 tablespoons of butter. And we're going to cut some sage. Chop some sage. And once your butter gets about golden brown, so let it go low and slow until it gets golden brown. It's a quick second from golden brown to burnt. So please watch it. Check it out. All right, once you start to get a little brown around the sides, it foams up a little bit, you're going to shut the gas, take it off the stove, throw the sage. See it going? A little bit of salt. It's going to toast the sage in the butter. This is when they go, oh my God, it smells so delicious, you should be here. So we're going to put this on the side. We're going to add this into the pot once we add all the ingredients. Sage butter. All right, let's check it out. Ah. So this, if you can see a little brown on the bottom of the pot? We're in business. This is cooked down just about enough. So now we're going to add everything to our soup. We're going to move out, unstick our butternut squash. Here's a little tip. Whatever doesn't come off just by doing this, leave it there. It's burnt. Everything's cool by now. We're going to dump the squash into this. Blech. All these little bits, all the oil, whatever's in there. Going to dump in our brown butter mixture. With our sage, of course. Going to add our stock. The recipe calls for 2 cups. They're full of shit. 4 cups or you're going to get baby food. You're going to have delicious tasting baby food, but give it a little stir. Gas put a little higher because it was really low and slow. Another half hour, let it simmer. Okay, I shut the gas off about a minute. You should have something that looks like this. We're gonna hit it with the emulsifier, the immersion blender, this magic stick, whatever you wanna call it. You can use a Cuisinart for this, but it takes a little bit of time. You gotta keep dumping soup in, it takes a while. Or you can use one of these. They're so easy, they're about 40 bucks. That's less than 3 times you're going to Chipotle. Save it, buy one of these. They're fantastic. That should be good. Okay, we'll do a little taste. The maple syrup is optional. But we do need heavy cream. Or light cream. I use light cream. Like that, a little by little. Give it a little stir. So, the cream, how much, Joe? You go by eye. So, it smells great. The color's amazing. This is an extra step that you don't need to do, but if you want it unbelievably smooth, you're going to put it through one of these little strainers here. And then just keep moving it around. For a little garnish, you can use a little ricotta salad or Parmesan, whatever you have in the house. Nice and thin. Crumble it on there. So there you have it, butternut squash soup. I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. You better have, because it took goddamn long enough. Stay tuned for the next episode of Joe Makes, and I'll see you soon.